Hi everybody, welcome to a Brooks Berdan video. My name's Ken Davis, I'm the director of sales here, and I want to thank Jamie Hart for being behind the camera and helping me get through this. This is the newest product from Mark Levinson, part of their 5000 series of integrated amplifiers. Before we get into it, if you're watching on YouTube, please do these things. Subscribe to our channel, like our video, and hit the little ring bell so you'll be notified next time we do a video. If you're watching on Facebook, be sure to share this with your friends. Appreciate that. So, we just got back from the home entertainment show that was in Long Beach this year. Los Angeles usually has a hi-fi audio show every year, and we took this with us so we could display it. And you know, a lot of people are like, wow, a new Mark Levinson piece. Well, it is exciting. Here it is on the cover of Stereophile magazine. Jim Austin, the reviewer at Stereophile, called this the very model of a modern integrated amplifier. It's a fully discrete, direct coupled class AB amplifier, and the manufacturer, Mark Levinson, rates it at 125 watts into 8 ohms, 240 watts into 4 ohms. And whenever we see an amplifier double in power, that's a very good sign that it's an extremely well-designed amplifier. It is capable of going all the way down to 2 ohms, at which point it produces 370 watts. That's an excellent amplifier design, able to do that. This integrated amplifier comes in two models. This one is the 5802, and it's an all-digital amplifier. Then there's also a 5805, and that has 4 digital inputs and 4 analog inputs, including support for a phonograph. So it has moving coil, moving magnet inputs, and those have adjustable loading. Key part to making your high-end turntable sound its best. This all-digital version is priced at $7,000, the 5802, and the 5805 has 4 analog and 4 digital inputs, and that's priced at $8,500. The digital inputs at the coaxial and USB inputs are available to go up to 384 megahertz, which is any material available pretty much. The USB does that, as well as DSD, up to 4 times DSD, which is 11 point. And based on all the features and the performance of this unit, it is an amazing value. It's definitely less expensive than just about everything else in its class. And to be able to own something this design, engineered, manufactured here in the United States at this price point and with this kind of performance and these kind of features is, I'm surprised. I really am. Todd Eichenbaum is the engineer behind this, who does the work with his team in Connecticut. He is a veteran of the hi-fi industry. He is a guru of amplifier design, and he's definitely hit this one out of the park. Jim Austin, in his Stereophile review, says the sound is great. He compares it to his reference system at $30,000 and says, you know what? If I wasn't in the business of doing the reviews, this is probably where I'd end up. Now, I'm paraphrasing for him a little bit. Let's talk a little bit about some of the features. This unit is completely controlled by a microprocessor. It can be interfaced with multiple different home control systems like Control 4, and it is network compatible. You can hardwire this to your network and get on there and do programming. I can turn off inputs that I'm not using, so when I switch back in here from, say, Bluetooth to AES or USB. If I don't have an AES input, I just turn that off. If I only have 2 inputs, all this knob's gonna do is switch back and forth between those 2 inputs. I can rename these inputs. If I wanna call it my OPPO CD player, if I wanna call it my DVR, whatever I like, I can put the name of each input on there. The other thing I can do is I can level match these inputs. So if my CD player or my streamer is playing louder than my turntable, I can dial that down or I can dial the turntable up. On the turntable input, there's also a unique balance adjustment. It's not unusual for cartridges to be a little bit hot on one channel or the other. Mark Levinson gives us a plus or minus 3 dB adjustment, balance left to right, so you can equalize that out. And that's important when we're talking about a high-end unit like this, and we want to achieve proper signal out of each channel so that we create that great stereo image. Because when the stereo image is correct, it's like holographic, and this unit is more than capable of doing that kind of thing. When we talk about some of the unique features at this price point, you can get on your network, go into a standard ordinary browser like Internet Explorer or Chrome or Safari, put in the MAC address for this unit, and bring up its control interface. That's where you would go in and update things like the drivers for the digital section, the microprocessor control firmware. This can all be updated. As Mark Levinson, this is a new product, so I feel pretty confident that Mark Levinson is going to be providing some updates for it. The moving magnet and moving coil inputs. This has a particularly excellent moving coil input with a substantial amount of gain, which is important, especially if your moving coil cartridge is a little low on output. If you don't have enough gain, it's just gonna sound lazy. We need to give that moving coil cartridge a lot of drive so it can keep up with everything else this integrated amplifier does. And the extra gain in the moving coil section of this does that justice. It really does. We also have adjustable loading, so we can adjust the capacitance and the resistance of the moving coil, moving magnet inputs, so we can match other cartridges on different tables with different cable combinations. We're able to do it all on this unit. It's like a Swiss Army knife. That interface on the network monitors the amplifier. We can see the DC output. We can see the positive and negative rails of the power amplifier. It monitors the temperature. We can go in and look at the temperature. If there's a fault, it stores the fault in a file, and a service person can go back and look at that file. I don't know about you, I'm probably a little geeky. I'm fascinated by that stuff. I can just watch the temperature build and go up and down as I'm playing it loud and soft. It was amazing, absolutely amazing. Comes with a beautiful aluminum remote control. Before we go, we're going to do a little listening, but I took the liberty of opening this up and going through this unit with our service manager, Tom Carrione. So I'm going to pull the lid off and we'll get some shots inside here. It is super well built. Now your unit probably won't have a removable top because I had to take some screws off. But up front here is a huge toroidal transformer. And this is one of the things that gives it the power to just rock it. It's a forward amp. It sounds like it's got power to spare, and this is why. This is a 62-pound unit, and I'm sure most of that weight is right here in this toroidal amp. It's a true dual mono design. The two amplifier, the output amplifier boards are mounted on separate parts of this chassis, and we can see them here. One of the things that Mark Levinson always likes to do, there's plenty of reserve power in these filtering caps for the output, and they're mounted right on the output board. So they're right next to the output devices. Let's give it a listen. We're going to listen to Holly Cole. I can see clearly now. And I'm going to set the volume up just a little bit. I really like this volume control. You have half dB increment adjustments, very precise. The sound is very intricate, layered, rich, a lot of drive in the low notes that really controls the bass exceptionally well. We get a wonderful sound stage that's deep, wide, very well placed on the instrumentals, especially on her voice. This unit sounds like a unit that would be easily cost so much more. I'm very impressed. Thank you all for watching. I'm going to remind everybody, if you're watching on Facebook, please share this with your friends. And if you're watching on YouTube, ring the bell, hit the like, punch the subscribe. Thanks so much, everybody.